Hello, humanity students. We're just entering into our last book, The Screwtape Letters. And this is the last book of the year, and I've really enjoyed having you in humanities. But I just want to give you a really quick introduction to this book. Again, we're going to revisit C.S. Lewis's works. As you know, he was an apologist, which means he was a writer who explained and gave proof that Christianity is to be believed and that what Christ did on the cross was truly what he said it was. And as you know, he started out his life as an atheist and eventually came to Christ. Well, as we read the Screwtape Letters, we need to be aware that there's a little bit of a different twist on how we read it. And so I just want to talk to you about that little twist. And if you look at my little graphic here, it's kind of a cartoony graphic, but it says, readers are advised to remember the devil is a liar. Okay, so this quote by C.S. Lewis is right in the preface of the book. And what he's doing here is giving us a warning that this book is written from the perspective of a demon and his nephew. Both of them are demons. And so the omnibus book kind of discusses, imagine that you were a World War II soldier and you found a Nazi guidebook, something that was top secret that you happened to stumble across, and it gave instructions and directions for how the Nazis would conquer the world. Well, obviously, you would have something very valuable in your hands, but it wouldn't be something that you would open and read and try to follow. It would be something that you would use as a guidebook of what not to do and possibly turn it over to the authorities so that they could maybe use it in an intelligence gathering thing and uncover some of the secrets of the Nazis. And so what our omnibus book wants us to do as we read this book is to look at it as kind of a guidebook of what not to do, because remember, it's letters between a demon named Screwtape and his nephew, Wormwood. Both of them are working on a person who they call the Patient. That's the only name they give him. And so the chapters in this book are short. He's giving advice to his nephew as to how to treat this man called the Patient, and to keep him from understanding the truth. And so tomorrow, as well, first of all, I want you to get started reading this, reading these letters. It's kind of a fast reading book, although the subject matter is more mature. And for that reason, I've asked the sixth graders not to read it. So this is just for seventh and eighth graders. But we need to look at it as a guidebook of how Satan and his minions might work on us. And so C.S. Lewis even gives us that warning by advising us to remember that the devil is a liar. So tomorrow we'll take a good look at the setting of the book as well as the main characters. There aren't very many characters in the book. And if you've already started it, you probably have already met them. So get started. This is your last book, as I said, and I think you'll enjoy it. It's really interesting. And just keep in mind as you read it that the devil is a liar. And we will see you tomorrow.